Hi, this is Mato. Welcome to my online chess lecture. In this video, I will show you a game between Hou Yifeng and Yu Yengyi. This is a game from the Chinese Championship 2011. Hou Yifeng had white pieces and she started with e4. Yu Yengyi played c5. I am sure that you know that Yu Yengyi, player with the black pieces in this game, is a very strong Chinese grandmaster. Hou Yifeng continued with knight to f3, knight to c6, knight to c3, knight to f6, and now bishop to b5, g6, h3, controlling g4 square, bishop to g7, e5, attacking the knight, sending the knight back to g8, bishop takes on c6, d takes on c6, d3, knight to h6, this is the standard move, and now g4, preventing knight to f5. Yu Yengyi castled kingside, queen to e2, f6, bishop to e3, knight to f7, attacking the pawn. On e5, how to defend the pawn? Or perhaps white should play bishop takes on c5. What would you do? Hou Yifeng castled queenside, f takes on e5, and black is a pawn up. White to move, perhaps bishop takes on c5 was expected. Knight to d2 was played. Let's see what is the purpose of this move. b6, defending the pawn on c5, and now h4. The queen is defending the pawn on g4. Black to move, h6 was played. So if h5, then black would play g5. Hou Yifeng played knight on d to e4. Bishop to e6, rook on d to g1, a5, seeking the counterplay on the queen's side, king to b1, a4, a3, rook to a7, queen to d2, king to h8, f3, and c4. White to move. What would you do in this position if you had white pieces? In this position, Hou Yifeng played a move that surprised everybody. Are you ready to see the move? People thought that only Tal can play like this. Knight to g5, sacrificing the knight to open the h-file. And there is no forced win for white. H takes on g5. Perhaps h takes on g5 was expected. Queen to h2 was played. This lady is full of surprises. King to g8. H takes on g5, threatening checkmate. But now, knight to h8, making the room for the black king to escape. Queen to h7 check. King to f7, and the king escaped. f4, intending to open the f-file, perhaps. C takes on d3. And now, f5, attacking the bishop. D takes on c2, check. King to c1, not taking the pawn. Bishop to c4. Rook to h2. Perhaps rook to d2 is on the menu. Rook to g8. f6. Pawn takes pawn on f6. G takes on f6. King to e8. Let's take it back. What's wrong with queen takes on f6? Then you see why rook to h2 was played. Rook to f2, winning the black queen. Back to our game. King to e8 was played. White to move, perhaps f takes on g7 was expected. Hou Yifeng played rook to d2. Queen takes on f6, knight to e4, attacking the queen, queen to e6, knight to d6, check, king to f8, and Hou Yifeng played knight takes bishop on c4. Knight to f7. It is white to move. Both players were low on time. In this position, bishop takes on b6 was played. With seconds on the clock, Hou Yifeng then played the strongest move. The strongest would be knight takes on b6, removing the target. In this position, Bishop takes on b6 was played, and Yu Yengyi played queen takes knight. And this is the end of the game. Yu Yengyi lost. You can argue that he could have continued, but you knew there was no point in continuing, because you lost on time. Yu Yengyi managed to defend well against a vicious attack, but it cost him a precious time on the clock. What a game. What do you think of this game? And that is all. I hope that you enjoyed watching this video. I wish you good luck with your chess, and bye for now.